Rescue and recovery crews on the ground in Washington state are struggling against tough conditions and a forecast of more rain. The mudslide happened about 50 miles northeast of Seattle in the small town of Oso. Jeff Brown has this update.
The National Guard joined the efforts earlier this week. Master Sergeant Chris Martin is a member of the search and extraction team. He joins us from Arlington, right near the site of the mudslide. Well, thank you for joining us. So what is the situation there today? Has it gotten any easier to do the work?
It seems like we've made a lot of progress from yesterday. We have two teams of 25 people working out in the site today. We're doing more of a systematic grid search through the area, and things look like they're moving in the right direction.
Well, we've been hearing for days about the quicksand conditions of the site and the difficulties of the search. How are you coping with that?
The conditions are very rough. If you can kind of imagine mud, the consistency of concrete before it sets, lots of trees strewn about. It's slow going, painstaking, and we just take our time to be safe and search through the debris field as carefully as we can to make sure that we don't miss anything.
We know there's always hope of finding someone alive still, but given what you've seen up there, do you think it's possible?
I'm a man of faith. I believe in hope, and I believe in miracles. I always would like to think that there's always a chance that we might find somebody.
I understand that more local volunteers have been allowed on the site today. That's after officials were trying to keep them away. What can you tell us about that?
I worked with quite a few local volunteers yesterday. They integrated with us well. You know, they have more at stake in this than the rest of us. And they got in right next to us and were assisting moving out the debris. They were very helpful, and we enjoyed working next to them.
This must be taking a toll on the rescue teams up there, the hard slog, sometimes the bad weather, and the slow pace.
We work in shifts, so we make sure that we don't burn ourselves out too quickly. We also have several chaplains on site to talk with us as kind of a de-stress situation, or to debrief us after we come off of the site. So I think that we're doing very well as a whole.
And I presume you have to take great care with every bit of ground and mud that you're working with.
Absolutely. It's kind of like they took a blender to the landscape, so you could find anything amongst the rubble in there. So we're very painstakingly searching through the area to find anything that might be of interest.
Have you yourself ever dealt with anything quite like this?
Personally, I have not. No, this is a new experience for me, but I'm definitely glad to be able to help the community of Oso. I'm from Washington State. I'm helping my fellow Washingtonians, and that's what the National Guard is all about.
Do you have any sense at this point about, given the difficulties you're facing, about how long this will go on? Is it days, weeks, even longer perhaps?
It is certainly going to take a while, and the National Guard will be there as long as the local say that they need us here to be.
Master Sergeant Chris Martin of the Washington State National Guard, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.